Hey Matryoshkev, it's hohonuts. So what is Telegram? And who is this guy, Pavel Durov, that stands behind this privacy-centered app? Well, alright. Telegram is a privacy and security-centered messenger. It was built by a famous Russian programmer and young businessman, the so-called Russian Mark Zuckerberg, Pavel Durov. He's the former head of a popular Russian social network, ВКонтакте. Just right after the 2014 crisis, after he allegedly refused to give out the information to the law enforcers, he was ousted. So, grabbing a handful of cash, he and his team traveled abroad, secured their funds, and started working on a new project, which is by now the famous security-centered messenger Telegram. And I personally started using it as soon as it came out and I knew that it was a project of our so-called exiled famous programmer. And really, ever since installing it, I've been falling in love with it more and more. I can't even recall if I've ever uninstalled it at least once ever since. The main point of this messenger is that it's built around the notion of privacy. And so in Telegram, everything is built with security and cryptography and whatsoever in mind. Basically, breaking it into pieces, it's a messenger that has the most secure level of communicating that you could ever imagine. All messages are encrypted by default, and there are two modes of communicating with people. There's an option where your messages are actually stored on the servers and they are still encrypted, so everything is okay. But in case you are too concerned with your privacy and you don't want anybody else to see your particular chat with whomever it could be, there's a second option, like super secret chat, and that one is not stored on any servers at all and uses like only two devices between the participants. So they store all the data of this communication, and it can be obtained by a third party because it is encrypted using RSA encryption method, if I'm not mistaken. So when you're done, you're actually free to delete your chat and it disappears forever, like it has never existed before. The second pro point about this app is, of course, the team and the ideology of this team. And the best proof for that notion is that as long as Durov had been the head of the ВКонтакте company, it was doing pretty well. It was the most popular social network in all Russian-speaking countries. And actually, despite it being a so-called rip-off of Facebook, it has found its own way to stand out as a unique web service. And pretty much everyone I knew loved it. And Durov's personal case kinda stands for him and his newly built project, because when he has been forced to give out the information, he stood for it and tried to defend his position. It speaks good about his intentions and the way he treats company and users, which is quite compelling and really rare in the modern world. Not many companies, I think, exist without relying on user data and selling ads. And I guess he has the opportunity to lead his life that way because he had good leftovers from his previous project. Basically, it's like a personal project and he's doing all the payouts out of his own pocket. As far as I know, he's vegetarian and libertarian. It's just FYI for your information. It doesn't prove anything. So, long story short, less talk, more action. Telegram is a present working app, so as they say, better show one time than explain it in 1,000 words. So you could just head on to Google Play Market or Google Store, what's it called now, or App Store, and just download it and try it out yourself. I'm sure you'll find it as a nice app as soon as you get the hang of it. So try it out. And if you do, here's the link to my backup space, to my channel in Telegram, which you could follow. I leave the link in the description below. There I'll be posting more of a controversial kind of stuff, which, say, could be taken down for copyright infringement issues. You know, there are plenty of cases of content being taken down of YouTube under this copyright issue claims, when in reality they fell under the fair use terms. So it's a really complicated issue where even if you're not trying to monetize the content, your content could possibly be taken down by hungry companies for so-called copyright infringement issues. Yeah, it's really complicated sometimes because occasionally videos are being taken down or monetized by hungry companies when they don't actually have legitimate reasons to do so. They just do so because there's opportunity, though such cases fall down under the fair use. Well, there are different type of content creators, but even in cases where fair use should be applied, there are a lot of problems. So I'm not endorsing the piracy, but there is an issue that could be avoided, and here's my plan to avoid any issues without making anyone feel bad. I'm not advocating for piracy. I am suggesting you to follow my Telegram channel, where I'll be posting videos that could be treated by unscrupulous companies as copyright infringement. So I think I'm gonna use it as an additional channel for my videos, where I'll be posting the content being referenced in YouTube videos. I'm planning to create a couple of videos on Russian media analysis, show you some really interesting cases of how media in Russia actually works. I think you'd be captivated by some of the instances. Hell, I'm sure about that. So don't hesitate. Try Telegram out. Follow this link in the description below and join my channel. And be ready to see some interesting stuff in addition to my videos. I think you'll be seeing a lot of really mesmerizing things. And by the way, Telegram is still being blocked. It was blocked more than a year ago in Russia. The funniest part is that Durov and his team has found a way to circumvent this ban, and so Telegram still functions in Russia, despite everyone knowing that it's being banned. But everyone still continues to use it, even the officials. And so, yeah, huge resources are being allocated to block this little app, little messenger, which causes so much trouble. The country of extremes. Not the extremists, by the way. Extremes, like Maximus. Hot and cold. We can't live in the golden mean. Only by the sides. So anyway, nice to see you again, and see you in my next video. Don't forget to join the channel. Bye. Don't forget to join the channel. It will be good. Yeah, but it should be good. It's gotta be interesting. I bet it will. And all these things. Yeah, thank you. Bye.